Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today in this video I am going to show you how to install latest version of MongoDB, that is MongoDB version 7.05 on a Windows operating system. And after that I am also going to show you how you can easily create your database on our MongoDB, then how to create collection, how to insert data, all of that on this video. So this video is going to be a bit long, but I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. So please do like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to share with your friends. That really motivate me to make more such videos. And if you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sessions. I'll try my best to help you. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install MongoDB on your Windows operating system, the first thing that you need to do is you need to go to your favorite browser and to just simply search over here MongoDB download and hit enter, and immediately you'll be seeing this MongoDB community server download link. So you have to open that link and it's going to redirect to the official site of MongoDB. You can see we are redirected to the official site of MongoDB. So this link I'm going to put right in our description, so that will really help you to come to this official site of MongoDB. So always remember that we are downloading the community one. So you can see MongoDB community server is what is selected. You know, if you download something else like MongoDB Atlas or MongoDB Enterprise, you know, all these things, then you might ended up seeing a different, you know, software altogether, and you might see errors even, because you know others are not available for community, right? So those are paid one, but the community one is the one that I am going to show you on this video, and that is totally can use if you are a student and all, right? So MongoDB community server is the one that is I am downloading. Always remember that. So here you need to scroll down and you can see we have option called select package. So just simply click on that, it will show you this one. So you can see the current version at the time of making of this video is version 7.2.5. if you want to download some, you know, older version like version 6 or 5 or 4, even you can, you know, always, you know, choose from this drop down. I'm going to choose the default one or the latest one, which is 7.2.5, and platform will be Windows x64, and MSI package is what I'm going to download. All right, so yeah. So keep everything as a default, click on this download button and it's going to start downloading our MongoDB. You can see it is rightly started downloading, right? I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser, I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our MongoDB is rightly downloaded over here. So always download the correct file, whatever I have showed you on this video. Just following that step, you need to download the right software. And once you have the right software, just simply double click on the installer. So welcome to MongoDB 7.2.5 setup. So let's minimize our download directory. So here you need to just simply click on next. So this is our license agreement. You can always read this license agreement, then accept the license agreement, click on next. So now, you know, under choose or setup type, they have given one is complete one, another is the custom one. I'm going to recommend you to select the complete one. So just simply select that, and it's going to show you this service configuration page. So here you can see we have this install MongoDB as a service option is rightly selected. So that's a very important one. I hope you know about services and all. So if you go to search and if you just simply type service over here, you can see you have services. If you open that, you can see you have so many services, right? So many of them are running. So like this, they're going to create one more service called MongoD. That name of the service will be as a service. So, you know, that's a very important. So always, you know, keep that checked. And run as service also is important, you know, select that radio button, basically keep that default, and MongoDB will be name of our service, right? So that is fine. Now they are also going to create a data directory and a log directory, so that also you can see the file path, right, for both data and log. So everything you need to keep default, do not tamper anything, just simply click on next. So install our MongoDB, install MongoDB Compass as well. So MongoDB Compass will give you a GUI interface. So that's very important again, you know, keep that mind that to check this and click on next. and ready to be installed. Click on install and there you go. You can see our installation is rightly began. First thing, it will ask you about administrative privileges. Click on yes and you can see it is rightly started installing our MongoDB. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. And you can see that our MongoDB is rightly installed. Now it is installing MongoDB Compass. And it is rightly launched also. Right, our MongoDB Compass. So welcome to MongoDB Compass node. And it has also installed our MongoDB. Right, so everything is properly set. Just simply click on finish of our MongoDB. So it is rightly installed. Let's maximize our MongoDB Compass. So here, let's click on start. And you can see our MongoDB interface properly in open. So this is our URI. So MongoDB, then :// then localhost, then our port number, which is 27017. So everything is properly set. You can just simply click on connect to connect with our MongoDB. So you can see it is properly connect. So if you click on this database, you can see we have all system databases properly showing. So one of them is local, then config and admin. So here first I'm going to show you how to create database. So for that, click on this create database and give a database name. So let's give the database name as a demo db, and you can also give your collection name. So let's give the collection name as employee, and I'm going to click on create database. So what it's going to do is it's going to automatically going to create our collection along with our database. So demo db.emp is our database and then collection name. Now you can tell, like, you have showed me how to create collection using database, but how to separately create a collection, right? So for that, you need to hover over your database that you have created and click on this plus icon, and here you can give another collection name. Let's give the collection name as department, dept I'm giving. Click on create collection and you can see we have two collection, right? One is demodb.employee and then we have demodb.dept department, right? So in on our employee collection, let's add some data. So you can click on this add data. If you want to import any existing data, you can always click on import JSON and you can choose your CSV file from here, CSV or JSON, whatever. All right, so I'm going to click on insert document. So I'm going to show you how to insert some of the data. So if you click on this hamburger icon, you can see we have insert document over here. So here, if you hover over this, you'll get this plus icon. Just simply click on that, add a field after ID, and I'm going to name that. I'm going to give that name of that field is name. Then simply give tab on your keyboard and you can give a name. I'm giving a name as show dog, and I'm going to click on insert, and you can see one data is rightly inserted on our collection called employee. Similarly, you can add one more data, like insert document, click on the hamburger icon, click on plus, add a field after ID, give the name, tab, and I'm giving another name. Click on insert, and you can see another data is created. You can do all the card operations. If you hover over this, you can edit the document, you can edit this name, you can delete this also, remove. If you click on delete, it's going to delete. You can clone this data, like clone. You can modify anything if you want, or you just simply hit insert. You can see it is rightly cloned. And all that you can do, right? All the card operations. So in my previous videos, I have already made a detailed video about MongoDB. I have also showed you how to use Mongo shell on that video. So if you're interested into MongoDB shell, that also you can do. Alright, so regularly I'm posting more videos on MongoDB. So if you're interested, you can always subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. So to get more videos on programming and coding related videos, right? And if you're also interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script vlogging channel. So that will really motivate me to make more such videos. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.